Very happy morning to all of you students. Students, today we are going to do the next part of the chapter, separation of substances. Now the next part that we are going to do now is purification of drinking water. We all, almost all of us, have the public supply of water, right? Municipality supply of water we all have. Now how that water reaches us, what is the process that is used by the government to clean that water, that we are going to do in this process. Okay, so the number one is, the step one is screening. Now what is this? In this screening, the water is allowed to pass through a big screen of wire net, you can say, which just sheds the impurities, leaves, insects or pebbles, whatever there are in the water. Means the solid and the bigger impurities, wo yahi pe shed ho jati hai, yahi pe hata di jati hai. Then the water, after the removal of these bigger impurities, is allowed to pass through the sedimentation tank. Now we have done the process of sedimentation. What is in sedimentation? In sedimentation, the bigger impurities, they are allowed to settle. Okay, means the water here is standing water and the impurities in it are allowed to settle down. So when the impurities, they just settle down, then the clean water is passed through the loading tank. Now what is loading tank? There are some impurities which are bigger in the size, which just settle down on standing, but there are some impurities which are smaller in the size and thus they do not settle down. So to make them settle, we used to add some external compound in it, like here alum is added. Now that alum, it just increases the size of the impurity and helps it to settle down. So that process is known as loading. जब आप एक external impurity से एक अंदर जो उसकी छोटी impurity होती है उसको बड़ा करके उसको आप settle करते हो, ठीक है, उसको आप sediment करने में help करते हो. Now after that, the relatively clean water is allowed to pass through the fine filter, that is the sand filtration. Now what is this? Sand is a very good filter, okay? Sand, whenever water is passed through the sand, sand entraps the impurities present in the water, which may involve microorganisms or some dusty impurities which we otherwise can't see. Okay, jo sand hai wo us sabko filter kar leti hai, apne mein entrap kar leti hai, rok leti hai. After that, the water, the clean water is allowed to pass through the chlorine tank, that is where the chlorination is done. Now in this tank, the chlorine tablets are added to the water so as to kill the microorganisms or germs present in the water. Okay, and after that, the purified water is made to store in the storage tank, from where it is then ready for the supply and is supplied to homes. Okay, so in this way you can see that the water purification involves a 5-step purification process, that is, number one, passing through the screen, that is screening, then sedimentation, then loading with the help of alum, then sand filtration, then chlorination, and then storage. And after that, the water is made to pass to homes, or it is supplied to homes through pipes. Okay students, so this is the whole purification process. Next is solution and solubility. The next topic is solution and solubility. Now before doing the solubility, let us first make ourselves clear with the concept of solution, that what is a solution. Solution is when you mix two or more substances in each other. We said that we get a mixture, we get a solution. The substance in which addition is done, that is known as solvent, and the substance that you add is known as solute. Like if you are making sugar solution, so you will add sugar into water. So sugar there is solute and water there is solvent, and both of them collectively is known as solution. Means after mixing solute into solvent, we get solution. Fine. Okay, now the amount of solute that a solvent can have, ek solvent apne andar kitna solute le sakta hai, ya the amount or the ability of a solute to get dissolved in a solvent, ki kitna solute aap dissolve kar sakte ho in the given amount of solvent, usko aap kya kehte ho? Solubility. Samajh aaya? Jaise agar aapke paas suppose ek gilas pani hai, to usme aap kitni sugar dissolve kar sakte ho, उसको आप क्या कहते हो, सॉल्युबिलिटी. गॉट इट? सो इट इज द एबिलिटी ऑफ अ सॉल्यूट टू गेट डिजॉल्व इन अ सॉल्वेंट, दैट इज नोन एज सॉल्युबिलिटी. ओके, नाउ अब देखो क्या होता है. यहाँ पे मैंने क्या यूज़ किया, मैंने आपको बोला कि एक गिलास पानी में आप कितनी शुगर डाल सकते हो, मतलब क्या है, उसके बाद आप और शुगर नहीं डाल सकते. आप बोलोगे मैम जितनी मर्जी डाल लो, बट नो इट इज़ नॉट सच. जब आप पानी में शुगर ऐड करना शुरू करोगे तो स्टार्टिंग में तो वो बहुत जल्दी जल्दी डिजॉल्व होगी, है ना. उसके बाद जो उसका डिजोल्यूशन प्रोसेस है, यानी जो उसका डिजॉल्विंग प्रोसेस है, वो थोड़ा स्लो हो जाएगा. फिर एक पॉइंट आ जाएगा जब आप और शुगर उसमें डिजॉल्व कर ही नहीं पाओगे, ठीक है, क्योंकि कैपेसिटी जो है वो खत्म हो चुकी है. सो दैट इज नोन एज सैचुरेटेड सॉल्यूशन. उस पॉइंट पे हम उसको क्या कहते हैं, सैचुरेटेड सॉल्यूशन. सो व्हाट इज सैचुरेटेड सॉल्यूशन, नाउ वी विल डू इट्स डेफिनेशन. अ सॉल्यूशन इन विच नो मोर सॉल्यूट कैन बी एडेड बट प्रोवाइडेड एट अ पर्टिकुलर टेम्परेचर. मीन्स इट शुड बी डन एट अ पर्टिकुलर टेम्परेचर, यू शुड नॉट हीट और कूल द सॉल्यूशन. ओके, मीन्स जब आप शुगर ऐड कर रहे हो, अगर आपने सपोज आप टेबल पे रख के उसमें शुगर ऐड कर रहे हो, तो आप वहीं पे उसको ऐड करते रहो. ओके, यू शुड नॉट इंक्रीज द टेम्परेचर. नाउ व्हाई वी शुड नॉट इंक्रीज द टेम्परेचर, बिकॉज टेम्परेचर इफेक्ट द सॉल्युबिलिटी. अगर आप मान लो एक ठंडे पानी में चीनी डिजॉल्व करते हो और गर्म पानी में चीनी डिजॉल्व करते हो, तो गर्म पानी में इजीली डिजॉल्व हो जाती है एज कम्पेयर टू द कोल्ड वाटर. इट मीन्स टेम्परेचर का ही फर्क है ना दोनों में, है तो पानी है. So it means temperature has an effect on solubility. Okay, so with the increasing temperature, solubility increase hoti hai, and by decreasing temperature, it just decreases. So that's why whenever we are doing the definition of saturated solution, we say that it is the amount of solute that can be added in the solvent, but at a particular temperature. Okay, students, so this is solution, solubility, and saturated solution. I hope that you all are aware, you all understood the concept of all these three terms, ki solution kya hota hai, solubility kya hoti hai, aur phir saturated solution kya hota hai. Fine bache? Then students, there is a small topic, that is water as a solvent. That is ki in that topic they have just explained the importance of water, because water is also known as a universal solvent, because it can dissolve almost every compound, every substance in it. Okay, so that's why whenever it is the term solvent come, the water, it automatically came into our mind. Okay, otherwise also water is very much important for us, because it helps us in our bowel movements, jo hamari body ke andar stomach digestion processes hoti hai, blood ki circulation hoti hai, waste product removal hota hai, us sab mein water helps us a lot. Okay, so that's why water is very much important for us. So this finishes with your chapter, students. I hope that you have understood the chapter. Thank you. Have a nice day.